I'm Paul Nguyen from Blue Hour Photo Ventures, and I'm going to show you how I used Sun Surveyor installed on my smartphone to help me make this photograph of the Milky Way over old Route 66. This was taken in Petrified Forest, Arizona, with special off-hours access granted to me by the National Park. In landscape photography, conditions are everything. During the day, this old Studebaker that marks where Route 66 used to cross through Petrified Forest is interesting, but not exceptional. The Arizona high desert in April usually has fairly clear skies, so even though there are some clouds in this midday shot, the forecast called for the skies to clear, and the chances of getting a dramatic sunset shot were going to be low. So, in this scenario, I had seen this old car during the day, on April 2nd, and moved on from it to shoot other things in the park, and later thought, since it's likely to be a clear night, that car would be a great subject and location to return to for a Milky Way shot. Since I was no longer on location, I couldn't use live view to predict exactly where and when the Milky Way would appear relative to my subject, so I figured I would plan the night shot using just map view and the 3D compass. If you need additional help understanding these modules or the basic functions of Sun Surveyor, I have separate tutorials on those that you should also watch. I used the satellite map layer so I could use landscape features to pinpoint my precise location, since this spot doesn't exactly have a street address I could look up. By dragging around the map, I was able to find the old car and use this as my location. When you have a location you know you'll return to, it's handy to be able to save your location for later use. And you can access your saved location easily by touching the open icon. So the most important information for this shot is provided by the Milky Way info panel. It tells you when the Milky Way center will be visible. The center is the brightest and most detailed part of the Milky Way, which makes for the most interesting photographs, as opposed to the edge of the galaxy, which would be seen on the opposite side of the sky. The Milky Way's center was going to be visible between 12:45 and 4:36 a.m. Late nights are just a part of the deal when it comes to Milky Way photography in the spring. So visibility in this case refers to the hours that the Milky Way center is both above the horizon and not being interfered with by light from twilight in the hours before the sunrise, which would make the Milky Way less visible as the sky gets brighter. I used my timeline to move forward in time into the night, actually going past midnight into the next day, April 3rd. Here you can see this white stripe on the timeline that represents the span of time where the Milky Way center would be visible. The Milky Way center visualization appears here, but the map view is a very flat representation of the world, and it's difficult to see the angle of the Milky Way relative to the Earth. So a better way to visualize this is with the 3D compass, so I switched over to that. This was a much better representation of the Milky Way looming in the southern sky, and I was able to see how the angle changed as I moved forward and back in time. I wanted a shot where the Milky Way was as high up in the sky as possible, so I was going to shoot for the back end of that span of time, between 3:30 and 4:30 a.m. You see that when I advanced too far in time, the Milky Way turns gray, meaning its visibility has decreased due to light pollution from the twilight. You'll also see the Milky Way turning gray when there's interference from moonlight. If you happen to see a Google Street View icon on your map, you can touch that to get a 3D visualization of your location with the Milky Way prediction when you're not on location. And if you go to the Photo Opportunities info panel, you'll see all the upcoming times when the Milky Way makes an appearance, so you don't have to just wait for the new moon to shoot the Milky Way. So, I returned to the old car on Route 66 in the wee hours of the morning, faced south, and made this shot at 4 a.m. If you have any questions about this shot or photo tours run by Blue Hour Photo Ventures, email info@bluehourphotoventures.com or visit www.bluehourphotoventures.com.